let's get busy with talking about Eclipse. If you've installed Java and you've installed Eclipse and you start it up, you get a splash screen, and then you get something that looks like this that asks you to select a workspace. Now, a workspace is just terminology for a folder that Eclipse is going to manage for you. Okay? So you can put this folder anywhere you want. If you're doing this in the lab, don't put it on the C drive, because the C drive is sort of kind of local to the machine. You're better to put it on your network drive, and then it will, if nothing else, be much faster off of the network drive. Okay? At home, it really doesn't matter where you put this folder. Now, another interesting thing about Eclipse is it's designed as sort of a high-level product for, you know, programmers who are working for possibly a bunch of companies and doing a bunch of different programs at once. And so a lot of the stuff that we're going to see initially looks sort of empty, and it's like, why would they have this option when you only ever choose this one thing? And so I'm going to try to explain some of these, this emptiness, and describe how it would actually be used. So here's the first case. This workspace folder could be anywhere. And if you were a programmer working, doing contract work for a bunch of different companies, you would probably have a separate workspace folder for each of the companies you were working for to keep them all separate. Okay? So there's that folder concept. In this class, you're probably only ever going to have one. And there's an option there that says just use this one as the default and don't ever ask me again, in case you just want to do that for the entire term. When you're in Eclipse, there's a way of changing that, so don't worry about setting it here. Okay? But I'm just going to leave that splash screen up, because sometimes I change workspaces. And there's no problem, for instance, a lot of students, when they start this class, they make a whole bunch of mistakes and they sort of mess up things. There's no problem with just abandoning the old workspace that you've got and making a different workspace with an entirely different name. All of the old stuff will still be there, and there's still a way of accessing it. Okay. So I'm just going to use the default and say OK. What I will actually end up having is a workspace folder for class number one and another workspace folder for the other section. So there's that idea of keeping them separate.
This is different.
Okay. What you get with Eclipse is this splash screen. And just let me fit it into my recording window so that you can see all of it. Okay. Now, the splash screen is basically for old folks. It's got the big buttons, you know, and you can press and hopefully get help on stuff. And we're just going to ignore it. So if you close up the welcome screen, you get the more of the default. Okay. Now, the screen is split into four basic areas. The stuff on the left, this thing called the Package Explorer, is just a file viewer. Okay, so it's just a file system viewer. There's nothing really special about it, except that it purposely limits you only to the workspace folder. Okay, so you can think of that workspace folder as the thing that Eclipse is managing. It's a bad idea to take stuff using something like the Windows file